Oh, that was, there's been a, the, you know, the last year or so, there's been a number of pitchers who look as though they're pitching from the stretch when indeed they're pitching from the windup. So the umpires always want clarification when there's a guy on third base, whether the pitcher's going to pitch from the stretch or the windup. And then there's also a discussion about, you know, how Russ quick pitches at times, whether that is going to be balked or not. So that's the gist of it. So I think, you know, fielding had to come in from third base to sort of help explain that to all of us. So that was it. I think there's, same thing's going to happen when John Gray comes back, as he sort of looks as though he's pitching out of the stretch when induced from the windup. And there's a number of David Price, there's others around the league that umpires can get confused, and runners as well. So that was the discussion.
What did you see tonight from Chatty? We've talked about the ball strike ratio. Sure. The walks way up.
Yeah, I think it was more mechanics than anything. I think that, you know, I saw the front side pulling off. I saw a little bit of direction, you know, more towards the left-hand batter's box. You know, threw a lot of fastballs below the strike zone. You know, so that tells me that, you know, the stride might have been a little bit long. He might have been, you know, just a little bit off direction as he was coming down the mound. And I think I saw at times, you know, a little bit quick off the rubber, a little bit, you know, rushing a little bit, as we call it, sort of coming down the slope, and the hands not quite separating quickly enough to let the arm catch up.
Did you notice that right away in the first? His first inning was not that bad. There was the one walk, but he was mostly pretty efficient. Did it change after?
Well, yeah, no, he struck out Utley, right? Struck out Peterson, right? Then he walked Turner, then got Bellinger. Yeah, it seemed to be, you know, in the third inning is when it really, you know, got complicated for him mechanically.
Do you think possibly the rushing that you mentioned is a factor of missing out offensively in the first inning against Kershaw? Kind of had it bases loaded against him, the team did, kind of missed a moment. Was he maybe trying to?
I don't think so. No. I mean, that's just my opinion. I mean, you can ask him, but I'd say definitely not.
Yeah, we've seen some situations where the ball strike ratio in a few games where the walks creep up, then they go back down. Do you feel like he can be better at just making adjustments in game to where it doesn't happen?
You know, we talked about it every inning. I know that Steve and him, you know, discussed his mechanics between every inning. And he tried to make that happen. You know, with the 8 warm-up pitches in between, but he just, you know, just couldn't get on track. You know, just the third inning got away from him. You know, the second inning, you know, give up the first pitch homer to start the inning to Peterson. Then he walked the next fellow, and then, you know, then that guy ended up scoring. You know, it just sort of kept, you know, snowballing a little bit on him, and he just couldn't get out of it.
I wanted to ask you about that first inning, again, opportunity lost there against Clayton Kershaw.
Yeah, so you got to capitalize on those, at least get a run. You know, that was a tough one. I mean, he's, you know, we had him 30-plus pitches. You know, it looked as though we might be able to break through the first. You know, but, again, that shows the caliber of talent that he is to be able to get a strikeout with the bases loaded, and then to get the out after that as well.
And with him, it seems like when he gets out of something like that, the next innings he's very efficient. I mean, 10 pitches the next inning, 10 the next.
Well, yeah, I think, you know, he's a strike thrower. I mean, you look at his walks per 9 innings, his strikeouts. I mean, he's throwing strikes. He's not pitching around guys. He's going at you, you know, with 3 quality pitches. So, I mean, his efficiency, you know, as a result of him throwing strikes. You know, I assume now he's potentially leading the league in innings pitched. Him and Scherzer are probably 1-2, I would assume. I haven't looked. But you don't do that by not being efficient and being a strike.